Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to a trophy slash achievement guide for It's in the Writing, and for this we need to collect all of the text collectibles in the game. Now this is slightly misleading, as we also need to collect the voicemail in Old Town for this achievement slash trophy to unlock. So a couple of notes before we begin, the collectibles in the video are not actually in order, so it doesn't go 1, 2, 3. We're going to do this in sort of an easy to follow way, so east to west kind of thing, south to north, or north to south. So yeah, we're going to be doing that. If there's only like one particular collectible you want or particular area you want, such as slums or Old Town, check out the description because there's going to be tons of time links and timestamps, whatever you want to call them. Some collectibles require quests, so this is what you may be stuck on, because some collectibles you cannot unlock until you've done a quest or, you know, gotten up to a particular point in a quest. For example, quite a few collectibles actually require, you know, like inside buildings, which you cannot actually get into until you've, you know, done that quest. So that's a bit of a bummer, but I will tell you what quest it will require in the video. And yeah, voicemail counts towards a trophy as well. So with all that being said, let's get to it. Starting off at the slums, and we're doing all of the notes. So starting off at the far east as well, at the bridge, which I'm sure you can, you know, identify on the map, it's pretty easy to identify. So climb your way up to the top, where your safe house is. And yeah, I'm not entirely sure if this actually requires you to do the quest Voltage, which you get from the electrician in the tower. I think it also requires a couple of quests before you actually get this quest. The quests of quests. Yeah, there are some, like, chains of quests you need to do before you can actually get the quest we need for the collectibles. But yeah, climb your way to the top, and when you get to your safe house, there's going to be a note right next to your sleeping bag, so you can just grab that, and that's going to be note 12 to the far east of the map. So jumping off and swimming to the fishing town, which is I'm sure you know where it is because we actually come here quite a lot during the campaign, so I'm sure you know where it is, to the east of the slums map. And there's a bridge, of course, in the background. So jump through this window in this building where the shop is, and the collectible, or the note, is going to be in that bookcase. So jump off and then head to the other side of town, or at least to the other side, and come through here, and the next note is going to be on this bunk bed, on the bottom bunk, as you can see in the video. So heading southwest to the Red Cafe, the Red Flower Cafe I believe it's called, or this big red building here on the map, we're going to come part of a quest called Where's My Mother, and I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I do believe you will need to be, you know, need to have done that quest, or at least, you know, come here during that quest, Where's My Mother. You're going to come into the building, and the note is just going to be on this desk or table here beside the bed. So like I say, I'm not sure if you actually need the quest, but there is a red door, and I'm not so sure you can actually, you know, open it without that quest being active, or, you know, that far in the quest. Anyway, so note 7 and 6 is going to require, you know, Gunslinger. We need to have actually completed Gunslinger. This quest can be found in the tower when, you know, that guy asks you if you can find him a gun. You're going to come back to him with a gun, and then he's going to give you the keys to the pawn shop. And this is the pawn shop, so the next two notes are going to be in his pawn shop. Of course, the first one being, you know, just underneath that till, and then the next one is going to be to your right, you know, in the storeroom. The door's actually going to be in your way when you actually first come here, so it's going to be hidden behind that door. Following the road south, we are going to come to this building, and again, we're going to need another quest called A Survivor's Guide to Zombieland, because if you don't have that activated, we won't be able to pick lock this door and get the note. You can get the quest from a guy in the fishing shantytown, I believe. Or I think it might actually be the other one where it's like a floating container thing. I'm not entirely sure. That little island just north of the fishing shantytown. So heading south of that location is going to bring us to the power station. And I do not believe this requires any quest, but if it does, then it's actually going to be a quest you get before you get the quest called Voltage, which was the collectible for on the bridge. So yeah, you'll get this collectible before you get the one on the bridge. That's if you, you know, get the collectibles during the quests. So then we're going to head back up to the tower, and right outside of the tower, just straight in front of you when you come out of the front door, is going to be a wall, and it's going to be like a memory wall. And there's going to be a note just, you know, beneath that wall, as you can see in the video. It's just going to be on the floor next to a picture frame, I believe. This may be the wrong way round, but we're going to head back inside, and you may actually already have got this note, but this note is going to be on the notice board, and it's just going to be right there on the notice board. Pretty easy to see there. You may already have this, because that is probably one of the first ones you'll get, I believe. So just northwest of the tower is going to be a little compound, a pharmaceutical compound, I believe. I'm not entirely sure because I haven't been here before I did the quest, but during the quest called Goodnight Mr. Bahir, we're going to come to this sort of drug dealer's compound, and the next note is going to be inside the compound, or the building, should I say. So yeah, I'm not sure if the shutters will be down, you know, if you haven't done that quest, which they probably will be. But anyway, this is number one, note number one. So to the far north of that location is going to be the Stuffed Turtle Supermarket. You may have already been here. This is a pretty cool location. I love supermarkets. I don't know what it is with me and zombies and supermarkets. You know, like Dead Rising 2. The music is awesome. It gets that feel of like a zombie takeover when you have a supermarket music sort of thing. But anyway, the note is just going to be right on the door. You know, just there on the front door. So heading north from the supermarket is going to bring us to an antenna mast, and this is going to be a safe house. We're going to come here during like the third quest, I believe, when we're working for Rice. So yeah, you may have already been here before, and the note is actually going to be in one of these buildings on the ground floor. So just jump off the antenna, you know, land into this bag of rubbish, and it's going to be the building to your right. I'm pretty certain you can actually come here, you know, whenever you want. I don't think the doors will be locked. So heading west will bring us to an apartment block, which these collectibles actually also require another quest called Total Security to be activated at least. I believe you get that quest from Errol at the school. I'm not 100% sure on that. But yeah, these collectibles won't spawn unless you've got that quest activated. So you just climb up to the top, to the rooftops of the apartment block, and the collectibles are just going to be on the roof. So heading south of that apartment block will bring us to the school. And now I'm not entirely sure if you can get these quests before you've completed the story mission called Siblings. But yeah, if you can't actually get into the school, then yeah, I'm almost 100% sure that it would be that quest that, you know, you need to complete before you can actually talk to the people inside of the school and the, you know, get the collectibles. So of course, jump down from that green container and the note is going to be inside it, and then we're going to head on inside the school, and the next two collectibles are going to be just inside the school. Simple. So just southwest of the school is going to bring us to this spaghetti of a gas pipe sort of station, gas station. I don't think you need any quests to be activated or, you know, completed to get this next note. If there is a quest that you need to do, then it's definitely going to be a quest for Commander Jeff at Fort Jeff. But yeah, picklock the door and then smash your hand against this, you know, medical cabinet, and there is a note right in front of you. So yeah, I don't think any quest is needed for that one. So just south again from the, you know, the gas station is going to be the house with the smoke pouring out of it. So it's going to have a big marker on it. I'm not entirely sure why it has a marker for, you know, the house with the smoke pouring out of it. It's a bit strange. But anyway, yeah, I think this requires a quest called Tunnel Vision to be completed. And, you know, we'll be able to come into this garage, I think. But yeah, if the shutters are down, then obviously we're going to need to do some quests for Ryan, who is the guy who lives here. And so, of course, you know, the collectibles are going to be inside the garage and outside just on that chair, as you just saw in the video. So heading east from the house with the red smoke pouring out of it, the next three collectibles are going to be in close proximity. Two of the collectibles are going to be in this market, and the other collectible is just going to be a short walk south or north, I believe. Anyway, so the first collectible is going to be in between these two dudes here on this table near the cellar. And then the next collectible is going to be inside this witch's house. So I don't think this requires any quest to be completed. But again, if the door is shut, then you will need to do the quest called Witch Queen, I believe. But like I said, I don't think you need to do any quests for them collectibles. So head on up to the bridge, which is just nearby. And we're going to actually need to jump into this, you know, cornered off random square thing, so this other gas station sort of thing. Just jump off the bridge into the rubbish pile, and the note is just going to be on a cardboard box in the rubbish pile. So head southwest of that location, and we're going to go through a tunnel to get note number 19, which is here on the map, just, you know, north of Reese's Tower, or Rice, I think it is, Rice's Tower. Complicated name. But yeah, head on through the tunnel, and we're going to head through a maintenance room, I believe, to the, you know, to your left. Just head on through, and the note is going to be on a desk somewhere in here, if I find it. There it is, on the desk right there. So to the far southwest of the whole map is going to be this little small village. So to the far southwest of the whole map is going to be this small village. And we're also going to need to do the quest Mother's Day. Quite a fair way in, I believe, like a few objectives in. We're going to get an objective to actually enter this guy's house from the roof. So yeah, do a few objectives for Mother's Day and enter through the roof, and the note is going to be in his bedroom on the ground floor, just off of his front room. Alright, so now we're moving on to the notes in Old Town. So starting off in the north, I mean, there's only like 4 or 5 here, not terribly many. Maybe 6, 7 or 8, I don't know, not many. But yeah, we're starting off at the north, and this is going to require a quest called Health Potion, I believe, and a quest before that called Rupert the Gunsmith. And we get them quests at the Magic Fortress, which is just located just south of this location, actually. I think you probably get a quest from Troy's Tower, maybe. I'm not 100% sure, but yeah. Yeah, there's also a policy in doing collectibles in this game. Just complete all the quests you see on the map. Whenever you see a exclamation mark, just head to it and do the quest. So yeah, the note is just going to be behind the door when you pick lock the door and yeah, enter the building. Or you can, you know, come through the front, just open the shutters. But I decided to pick lock the door. Heading southeast to the fan zone. I actually recorded this because there's actually quite a lot of interiors in Old Town, and you will be able to return to these interiors later on in the game. So I just recorded this, you know, because I didn't think you'd be able to come back here. But you can, luckily, you can come back to all of these interiors. So that is in the fan zone, which is another quest. You'll probably hear the, you know, loudspeaker, that guy on the loudspeaker. Anyway, notes 27 and 28 are going to be part of another quest called Midnight Bride. And this time we're going to head on into a hotel. I'm not entirely sure why, actually. But yeah, the notes are going to be in room 101, I believe, and 107. something like that. But yeah, again, you can return here anytime you want, which is cool. For the second collectible here, I'm not entirely sure if you'll need a keycard, but if you do, then at the end of this clip, I show you where the keycards are held. In this hotel, there's like tons of keycards just behind the desk. And to get to that back room, you need a staff keycard, which is near a dead body. So yeah, I think you need a keycard for room 108. So yeah. So southwest of that hotel, overlooking the lake, is going to be Note 29, and again we're going to need another quest called Chasing Past. I think you get from that hippie, I believe. Not 100% sure. That guy with the music playing out in the northern part of the town. So you head on into the apartment and do the quest, and we're going to go up to the top floor, where it's apartment 3, I believe, and the note is just going to be sticking out the doorway. So if you've done this quest, you know, I'm not sure how you haven't got it, because, you know, you purposely missed it. You purposely, you know, didn't get it like I did. Because it is pretty in your face when you open the door. So you open the door and there it is, just hanging out. Kind of obvious. If you haven't got the note, then you probably haven't even done the quest. So just a little bit south of that, you know, that building is going to be another building where the next three notes are going to be on top of a rooftop. So here they are on top of this roof in this little block here. There'll be like two of them monsters just fighting each other, or at least fighting survivors anyway, down there. So yeah, the notes are going to be on top of this rooftop. So pretty simple. Pretty missable as well, because I've been over here quite a few times and just completely ran past them. Moving on to the battle journals, we're starting back at slums, starting again at the bridge. So I do apologise if this is a bit annoying, because we do come back. I just thought it would be better if we sort of split the collectibles up into, you know, the categories. It would be a bit easier to follow instead of getting muddled, higgledy-piggledy, you know, with all the collectibles. So yeah, starting again at the bridge. We're going to climb all the way to the top. But I've got a grapple hook, and the grapple hook is extremely useful. Super fun to use in Old Town as well. Kind of like Spider-Man. But anyway, yeah. You're going to get to that top sort of platform, and you're going to be able to jump off onto the zip line and zippy down all the way to the other side of the bridge. Now, this is also an extremely good area to loot. So yeah, the battle journal is here on the desk somewhere. I do apologise for being a bit vague, because I did accidentally collect it whilst I was, you know, just picking everything up. Because there's tons of medikits here. I went from about 10 medikits to about 30 or something here. It's just tons, it's ridiculous. They also respawn as well, so you can always come back and get like another 20 medikits, which is pretty damn good. So yeah, there it is on the map, of course, at the other side of the bridge. So head back to the fishing shantytown, and the next journal is going to be on top of that roof again, where we collected that note in the bookcase. We're going to jump on top of the roof, and that is where the next, you know, journal is going to be. On that chair, overlooking the scenery, very beautiful. Head northwest to the countryside, and there's going to be this random compound here, it's like in the middle of nowhere. Here it is on the map. It's identifiable by the roads, you know, that the curvy roads and everything. So there it is. And the battle journal is going to be inside the boot or the trunk of this green car here. This wrecked green car. And then we're going to head back to base, back to the tower, and this, I also accidentally picked this up as well. Journal number 0, it's called. It's on this shelf right there next to the quartermaster. It's pretty easily to be found. Easily found. I'm sure you probably already got it as well. Head upstairs to, you know, upstairs. And we're going to head to the sick bay, the medical room, which is this room here, to your left when you come out of the elevator. Just head straight on through to the ward. So it is, the makeshift ward. And next to this guy, there's going to be another battle journal. From there, we're going to head north to our first safe house, I believe. It's our first safe house we unlock when we first encounter a bolter as well, I think. So here it is on the map, just north of the safe house, the tower safe house. And yeah, this is another one I've collected as well, accidentally. So to your right is going to be a bunch of bags, and that in that crate is going to be the battle journal right there, which I, again, accidentally picked up, which I'm sure you probably picked up as well. Because if I've picked it up, I'm sure you have. So journal number two, we're going to find during the airdrop mission. This is actually the roof where the airdrop actually lands. So if you've watched my walkthrough for part one, you'll see that I overturn a dead body and there is the battle journal. But by then, I've realised that I shouldn't actually pick these up. So there it is, where the body is supposed to be. There's just, you know, the journal just left there in the middle of nowhere. So northwest from there is going to be the petrol or the gas station, as you Americans say. So yeah, there's going to be this nutcase on the rooftop just shooting at you. So this is the location where that guy is just shooting at you. So if you've got a gun or, you know, any weapon to kill that guy, and you liberate this outpost or safe house, the notebook, or the journal, should I say, is going to be to your right next to your sleeping bag. So yeah, that guy with a gun is the biggest problem, I guess. Southwest from there is going to be this bus station, from what it looks like, I think. It's going to be this bus station, but if this is your first time coming here, there's going to be a guy stuck in that bus, and you're going to have to help him. There's going to be zombies and everything. But yeah, once you've done that little mini-quest, you'll be able to unlock this as a safe house. So head inside, and to your right in this office is going to be the journal, right there on the desk. So heading north to the main bus station. You know, easily identifiable on the map with all these strips. It's going to be the, you know, big bus station with all the buses. Pretty identifiable with the buses. So head on inside to this building, to the waiting room, and right there in front of you is going to be the next journal on the bench. Surrounded by all the bags, tons of bags in this area. Heading a little southwest of the bus station is going to be this place here. I'm not entirely sure what it is, just a few strips of random buildings. Anyway, there it is on the map to the far, you know, northwest of the whole map. The next journal is going to be inside this room here and on top of the desk. So there it is. Southeast from the previous location is going to be a junkyard at a junction. You know, junkyard at a junction. And the next journal is going to be on a sofa inside the junkyard. So this is where it is on the map, just southeast of that previous location. Anyway, jump on through to the, you know, the junkyard. And the journal is going to be on top of this couch. So the next journal is not actually in slums as per se. It's actually in the sewers. But this is where it is on the map, or at least, you know, the entrance to the sewers. So you won't be able to get this journal until you've completed the quest where you're heading to Old Town, where you actually come to the sewers. I'm not sure what the quest is called, but yeah, if you haven't been to the sewers yet, you just need to complete the story until you're at the sewers, basically. Just, you know, follow the route like you do in the story campaign, and you're just going to storm through here, which is what I originally did in my first playthrough. Came in here and I was like, what? Where now? Where now do I go? But yeah, the journal is on this desk? On this chair, next to the teddy bear, in the corner. So this is what I did in my first playthrough. I was like, where the hell do I go now? Oh, you know, it's actually in the other room you need to go to get to Old Town. Speaking of Old Town, all of the battle journals in Old Town, there's only about four here, I think. Anyway, starting off in the northwest, there's going to be this river here. The river's just going to pass by this, is it a river? I don't know. It's a bit of a lake slash river thing. Anyway, body of water. So yeah, there's going to be a tunnel here. Just head on through, and there is the journal just lying on the floor there, inside this short tunnel to the northwest of the Old Town. So in the middle of Old Town is going to be a safe house, and this is where the next journal is going to be, and it's actually called Journal Epilogue, so it's obviously the final piece of the puzzle. So there it is on the map, right slap bang in the middle of Old Town, and we're just going to head on through to our safe house, and there it is. Just as soon as you jump down, it's right in front of you, or right behind you, depending on, of course, which way you jump down. Then heading just south from there at the bridge is going to be this massive office building where the outpost is. Pretty damn fun, those outposts were really damn fun, must admit. Good gameplay there. The lighting and everything, loved it. Anyway, I digress. Come through here and there's going to be a shelf here where the journal is going to be on top of the shelf overlooking the office building. And the final journal is going to be to the west of that office building, as you can see there, just in the background. And the journal is actually going to be on the ground floor. You're going to have to put up some shutters here with these monsters here, so they're a bit of a nuisance. So yeah, pull up the shutters, and the journal is going to be on this workbench here. So that's a bit of a nuisance. Yeah, he's blocking my way, damn it. So yeah, there we go, that's all of the journals and the notes for Dying Light. I have done a separate video on the voicemails, so you can check that out if you haven't got the voicemails yet. Because you do actually need the voicemails for the trophy slash achievement, it's in the writing to unlock. So I hope this helps, and thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and like and comment. And yeah, if you've got any problems, just comment, please do comment. I'll try my best to help. And yeah, thanks for watching.